folks, Will from MinIO here, and in this video, we're going to be talking about object retention, sometimes called object locking. And over the course of this video, we're going to be talking about worm, which is write once, read many. We're also going to be talking about duration-based holds and legal holds. This is all the different ways that you can lock an object to prevent accidental deletion or overwriting. So let's dive right in and we'll talk about worm, W-O-R-M. And worm stands for write once. And when we're talking about write once, what we're saying is if you upload the same object to the same bucket, basically to the same namespace, what you're going to see is that that object is going to be overwritten unless you have versioning on, in which case a new version will be created. You're only going to write it once. No modifications will ever take place to an object that has already been uploaded to MinIO. You're either going to delete the previous object entirely or you're going to create a new version. That's what's going to happen with write once. As far as read many is concerned, what we're saying here is the same object is guaranteed to be there forever, essentially. Objects are immutable. Once I've read it one time, I'm going to keep reading the same object in the same namespace. However, these objects are deletable unless you turn on some object locks, also known as object retention. MinIO allows your object to be locked, which makes them undeletable. That also means you can't overwrite them. That also means that the object will remain there until the lock expires. You can set locks either on a per object basis or as a bucket default so that any objects that get uploaded to a bucket will be locked by default. To use object locking, you must have versioning enabled. So hopefully you've already seen our video on versioning. If you haven't, now would be a good time to pause and go watch that one. Object locking has to be enabled at bucket creation. And also this means that at bucket creation, versioning will be enabled automatically. When you enable locks, you enable versioning. The actual retention rules, however, are set separately. All you're saying is this object can be locked in this bucket. You have to set the rule yourself. All right. What types of rules can we set? Well, we have a couple of different ways to do this. Duration-based rules and also legal holds. Let's talk about duration-based first. You have two different types of duration-based hold. You have governance mode is our first one. This protects objects from non-privileged users. Okay? If a user has the S3 bypass governance retention permission set on it, then it can override all of these things. It can modify the object. It can remove the lock. It can even change the duration of the lock. That's what bypass governance retention does for you. Now, the root user, the admin user that you stand up when you first start up MinIO, that user can always bypass governance retention because it has that permission set. As a matter of fact, all of the different built-in users that you have available, unless we're talking about the read-only or the write-only, have this bypass governance retention available to them. So that is something that you will need to set specifically to say, no, you do not have bypass governance retention. We'll show you how to do that when we get to our demo. The other mode that you have available for you is the compliance mode. This is much more strict than governance because it protects the objects from all users, including the root user. The object cannot be modified until the retention lock expires. That's it. Okay. So compliance mode and governance mode are the two different modes that you can set that are duration based. They have some common options. If you set recursive, that's going to apply to every prefix in the bucket. It's going to apply to all the objects in the bucket. If you set a default, you can set this on the bucket. That's going to apply to every new object that is added to the bucket. And there's also a dash dash versions flag that you can use to apply to all versions of the object. Or if you just want to apply your compliance and governance lock to a specific version of an object, you can use dash dash version ID for that specific version. Okay. So lots of different options available to you on how you set up your governance or compliance holds. The duration setting that you can set as a number of days or a number of years. 90 days would be 90D, 90D. And if you did like 1Y or 2Y or 3Y, that would be a lock for an entire year or two or three. Okay. So keep in mind that you can set this as days or years. and that allows you to have a lot of flexibility with your compliance and your governance locks. The other type of hold that you have is the legal hold. Legal holds are not time bound. What happens when you set a legal hold is you prevent deletion, again, by anyone, including the root user, until the legal hold is lifted. Okay? And you have to have some specific permissions to lift a legal hold. Now, the root user obviously has those permissions, but we'll show you what that permission is in just a second. A legal hold is generally set on a per object and version basis. Okay? You cannot set legal hold as a default. If you want to apply to every object in a bucket, you can use recursive. So here's the cool thing about legal holds. Your duration-based lock and your legal hold can work together. So you can have a governance lock for a certain period of time and a legal hold, which is going to be there until the legal hold is lifted. So this is going to keep your object from being deleted until both conditions are true. The legal hold is lifted and the retention lock conditions are met, whatever the length is for that. Okay. Again, this is overwritable if you have the right permissions, but again, we're going to show you how you can turn off some of those permissions. In order to use a legal hold, you have to have this put object legal hold permission. That overrides the governance permissions too, by the way. You cannot change the object even with bypass governance retention if you have put a legal hold on the object. So this prevents everything from happening if you put on this legal hold. And again, this is so not even the root user can delete it. Now, the root user could remove the legal hold and then delete it, but that's something you're gonna have to work out with your particular environment and your retention rules, okay? So let's take a look at some example commands that we have available to us here. First off, how do I make a bucket that has object locking available? Well, mcmb is the make bucket command. With lock is the flag that you're going to use that makes the locking available, and it also automatically enables versioning for you. Local is an alias that I have set up, and then we also have bucket as the bucket name. So this bucket on my local MinIO deployment is going to have locking available. Now note, locks are not in force yet because I haven't set any locking rules yet. Let's take a look at that. If I want to set a compliance lock, it's MC retention set. And then what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna say dash dash default, which makes it the default rule for everything in the bucket. Anytime I upload a new object to this bucket, it is going to be compliance locked. And that's the mode that I've set there. Compliance is the lock mode. You can also use governance as the lock mode. And then 90D sets the number of days. I could use Y for years if I wanted to. Set it for 90 years for all I care. All right. If I want to set two things together, I can do this. Here's an example where I'm doing the governance and the legal hold. Note that it's two different commands because the two locks are managed separately. My governance hold is MC retention set, just like I did for my compliance. I've changed compliance to governance here. Notice that the governance lock is set here across the entire bucket, but then when I want to set my legal hold, MC legal hold set has to have a specific object and possibly even a specific version if I needed to. The legal hold is per object. Okay, now this would set the legal hold on the latest version of the object, but not any other versions. I could use dash dash versions to set it on all versions of the object should I need to. Again, the legal hold is a complement to the governance lock. If after 90 days I wanted to delete something, I would still have to remove the legal hold. That's because both of these work together. So what happens if I want to try to delete a locked object? Well, it turns out you can. Wait a minute. Don't I need to have some permissions? It turns out that because we're using versioning, I can do an mcrm local bucket locked.png. If this is governance locked, if it's legal hold locked, doesn't necessarily matter because since I have a versioned bucket, versioning is enabled by default, what happens is this creates a delete marker. And a delete marker is a new version of the object. The original object and version still exists. And I can review that with mcls dash dash versions. If I want to delete a specific version, I can do that if I have bypass enabled, and I am allowed to do that with a governance lock, but not with a compliance lock or a legal hold. I can bypass governance if I have the right permissions. So what's going to happen is if I try to delete this non-current version, I'm going to get an error. It's going to basically tell me my access is denied to actually be able to do that. Or I'll get a note saying this is worm locked and I can't delete it. Now, here's the interesting thing. If I try to delete a delete marker in a locked bucket, I can do that as well. Delete markers are not subject to governance, compliance, or legal holds. The reason for that is there's really nothing to them. So there's nothing to protect. So we're okay with removing a delete marker, but you just cannot remove a version that is locked. Just a quick review on delete markers. We spoke a little bit more about delete markers in our versioning video, but deleting a delete marker has the effect of reinstating the prior version. So I'm not really deleting anything. I'm actually just reinstating the version that was already there, which is why you can bypass locking with delete markers. Your delete markers are propagated during lifecycle management. They're replicated during site replication, and they are not subject to locks. That's really all we have about this topic. What we're going to do now is in our next video, we're going to show you a little demonstration of how all of this works. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can connect with us on Slack at slack.min.io, or you can just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.